क्वेश्चन नंबर 20। 10 पॉजिटिवली चार्ज पार्टिकल आर केप्ट फिक्स्ड ऑन द एक्स एक्सिस एट ए पॉइंट 10 सेंटीमीटर 20 सेंटीमीटर 30 सेंटीमीटर 10 सेंटीमीटर 20 सेंटीमीटर 30 सेंटीमीटर दिस इज 10 दिस इज 10 दिस इज 10 एंड सो ऑन। So at an interval of 10 centimeter, 10 particles are kept. First particle, second, third, and so on. This is 10th particle. So your 10th particle is located at 100 centimeter from the origin. 10 particles, 10th particle, third particle, second particle, first particle. So 10 charges are kept at an interval of 10 centimeters from the origin, and every particle has different charges. First particle has 1 into 10 to the power minus 8 coulomb charge. The second particle has eight into 10 to the power minus 8 coulomb. Q1, Q2, Q3. Q3 is 27 into 10 to the power minus 8 coulomb. So first particle, that is 1 cube, second particle is 2 cube, third particle is 3 cube. Similarly, 10th particle will be 10 cube, that is 1000 into 10 to the power minus 8 coulomb. Now, they are saying, this is question number 20. Question number 20 of S.C. Verma. Find the magnitude of electric force acting on a 1 coulomb charge placed at the origin. At the origin there is a charge. At the origin 1 coulomb charge is placed. And you have to find force on this 1 coulomb charge due to all these 10 charges. So you will have 10 different forces and all will act in this direction. Because the charge which is placed at the origin is also positive, and all these rest charges or 10 charges are also positive. So they will repel that 1 coulomb charge. So all the forces are acting in negative of x direction, and you will have a force. If you sum up all these forces, you will get the result. So if F1 be the force due to first particle, it is going to be K into 1 coulomb into Q1, that is 1 into 10 to the power minus divided by separation. Separation is your 10 centimeter. 10 centimeter means 10 into 10 to the power minus 2 meter. This separation is 10 centimeter. So, if you convert it into meter, it is going to be 10 into 10 to the power minus 2 meter. So, it is going to be K into 1 into 10 to the power minus 8 divided by square 10 to the power minus 1. 10 into 10 to the power minus 2 is 10 to the power minus 1, and square of 10 to the power minus 1 is going to be 10 to the power minus 2. And if you calculate these, it is going to be K into 10 to the power minus 6 newton. Focus it. Now let us calculate second force. Force due to charge Q2. It is going to be K into 1 into second charge is 8. That is 8 into 10 to the power minus 8 divided by your separation is this time is 20 centimeter. For charge 2, the separation is your 20 centimeter. So 20 into 10 to the power minus 2 whole square. So after calculation you get K into 8 into 10 to the power minus 8 divided by 20 into 10 to the power minus 2. That is 2 into 10 to the power minus 1 whole square. 2 into 10 to the power minus 1 whole square. So it is going to be K into 8 divided by 4 into 10 to the power minus 6 newton. K into 8, 2 to the 4 and 10 to the power minus 1 into 2, it is going to be 10 to the power minus 2, and when it goes to numerator, it make it 10 to the power minus 6. Similarly for F3, what we get? K into 1 into 27 into 10 to the power minus 8 divided by, now the separation is 30 centimeter, so it is going to be 30 into 10 to the power minus 2 whole square. So after calculating, it is going to be K into 27 into 10 to the power minus 8 divided by 3 into 10 to the power minus 2 minus 1 whole square, and finally it will turn K into 9, K into 8, K into 27 into 10 to the power minus 6 divided by 9 newton. For third force, it is going to be K into 27 divided by 9 into 10 to the power minus 6. For 10th particle, similarly we can calculate for 10th particle, 10th charge, it will generate a force K into 1 into 1000 into 10 to the power minus 8 divided by 100 into 10 to the power minus 2 whole square, which is equal to K into 1000 into 10 to the power 8 minus 8 divided by 1 whole square, because 100 into 10 to the power minus 2 is equal to 1. 1 whole square is 1. 10 to the power minus 8 can be written as 10 to the power minus 6. I am doing another line. So it is going to be K into 1000 into 10 to the power minus 2 into 10 to the power minus 6. I am bringing 10 to the power minus 6 just because every force has 10 to the power minus 6 in common. So I will also make 10 to the power minus 6. So how can I make it 10 to the power minus 6? I can make 10 to the power minus 8. 10 to the power minus 2 into 10 to the power minus 6. So what we get, if 10 to the power minus 2 and 1000 cancels, it is going to be k into 10 into 10 to the power minus 6 newton. Clear? Now what do you find? 9 into 27 cancels, becomes 3. 4 and 8 cancels, become 2. If we add all these 4s, F is equal to F1 plus F2 plus F3 dot 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 F10, what we get? K into 10 to the power minus 6 is in common. K into 10 to the power minus 6 is in common. And inside the bracket, you will have 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 and so up to 10. It is going to be 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus dot 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 up to 10. The value of K is 9 into 10 to the power 9 into 10 to the power minus 6 and 1, it is n into n plus 1, sum of the natural numbers. So 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to 10, you will have 10 into n into n plus 1, n is your 10. So sum of the natural number is n into n plus 1. This is n into n plus 1 is 11 divided by 2. 5. That is 55. 5 into 11 is 55 into 9. This much newton. So it is going to be 55. 5 into 11 is 55 into 9. This 9. And 10 to the power 9 into 10 to the power minus 6. It is starting to be 10 to the power 3. Into 10 to the power 3. This much newton is acting, this much force is acting on this 1 coulomb charge. You can calculate it further. Okay?